Hello everyone, myself Ashwin, Assistant Professor in the Department of Civil Engineering, PES College of Engineering, Mandya. In today's lecture, we will discuss more about centroid. Let us study the definition of centroid and center of gravity first. Centroid is the point through which entire area of the plane lamina is assumed to be concentrated, whereas center of gravity is the point through which entire weight of the body is assumed to be concentrated. So here you have to understand that centroid refers to plane figures only, that is rectangle, triangle, circle, etc. While center of gravity refers to solids, and centroid and center of gravity is always the same for plane lamina. So we have to determine the centroid or the center of gravity for a plane lamina. Let's now understand how to do that. Now for this, you have to consider a plane figure which is of uniform thickness T, of same material throughout as shown in this figure. Now let W be the total weight of the plane acting at point G at a distance of X bar and Y bar from Y axis and X axis respectively. Divide this plane into a number of elemental areas as shown in this figure. Now let W1, W2, W3, etc. will be the weights of elemental strips acting at X1, Y1, and X2, Y2, X3, Y3, and so on. Now we know that the total weight will be equal to W1 plus W2 plus W3, etc. Now, according to Varignon's principle, we can state that the total moment that is due to this W into X bar is equal to sum of moments of individual forces, that is W1, W2, W3, etc. Therefore, we can write that WX bar is equal to W1 X1 plus W2 X2 plus W3 X3 and so on. Now, if you simplify, X bar will be equal to W1 X1 plus W2 X2 plus W3 X3 divided by W. But we also know that W is equal to rho AT, where rho is the density of the material, T is the thickness, which is constant throughout. Now, substituting for W, we can say that rho A1 TX1 plus rho A2 TX2 plus rho A3 TX3 divided by, again, W is equal to rho A1 T. So here, area is varying, that's why we have put A1, A2, A3, it is not constant. Now if you simplify that, taking the constants throughout, you will get X bar is equal to A1 X1 plus A2 X2 plus A3 X3 divided by A1 plus A2 plus A3. Now if you simplify that and generalize the equation for X bar, we can write that summation of AI XI divided by summation of AI. So in the similar manner, we can also derive for Y bar. That is, Y bar is equal to summation of AI YI divided by summation of AI. Now we'll derive the centroid for a rectangular section. Now consider this rectangular section of width B and height H as shown in this figure. Now consider a small elemental portion or a strip of thickness dy and width b, the same width of the rectangle as shown in this figure, and it is at a distance of y from the x axis. Now the total area of the section is given by, or the total area of the rectangle is given by b into h, whereas the area of elemental strip, that is dA, which is equal to this, the width of the strip and the thickness, which is dy. That's why area of the elemental strip is b into dy. Now first moment of elemental strip about x axis is given by dA into y. So this is dA and into the perpendicular distance y, that is br dA into y. Now the moment of whole area, that is the rectangular area about axis OX, will be obtained by integrating the above equation, that is dAy, between the limits 0 to h. Now the first moment of whole rectangular section is represented as integration of 0 to h dAy. So we are substituting the value of dA as b into dy. We will, and after simplifying, we can get that the first moment of area as bh square by 2. Now, from the definition centroid, we have y bar is equal to first moment of area divided by total area. Now, we have seen that the first moment of area is bh square by 2, and total area, that is the area of rectangle, is base into height, that is bh. Now, if you simplify this, you will get y bar as h by 2. Similarly, for x bar, we can calculate as x bar is equal to b by 2. Now, in the similar way, we can also derive the centroid for rectangular section. So, this figure shows triangular section. So, consider a triangular section of width b and height h as shown in this figure. Let us consider a small elemental strip of width b dash and thickness dy at a distance of y from the base, that is from the x-axis, as shown in this figure. Now, area of this elemental strip, that is, this is of rectangular shape, right? That's why its area will be b into dy. So, from the property of a similar triangle, we can write that b dash by b, that is b dash, that is this elemental strip, divided by b is equal to h minus y by y, h minus y by h, that is this is h minus y, that is of smaller triangle, divided by height of the larger triangle. So from the property of similar triangle, we can write that b dash by b is equal to h minus y divided by h. Now you can simplify and keep it for b dash, and also we know that b dash is equal to, from this expression we can write that b dash is equal to dA by dy, correct? Now, substituting the value there, so we can say that dA is equal to b into 1 minus y by h into dy, right? Now, from the first moment of this area about x-axis is represented as dA into y. That is, substituting again for dA here, b into 1 minus y by h divided by, into dy into y. Now, total moment of whole triangular area about x-axis is again, we will get that by integrating between the limits 0 to h. Now, integrating and substituting the limits, we will get the total moment of area as bh square by 6. Now, again, from the definition, we can say that y bar is equal to, that is, moment of area divided by total area, that is bh square by 6, whole divided by half into base into height, which is the area of the triangle. Now, if you simplify this, we will get the y bar as h by 3, which is measured from base. Now, in the same manner, we can calculate the centroids from the first principles for all the generally used shapes like right angle triangle, circle, semicircle, quarter circle, square, etc. Thank you.